Just going to be doing a little work on this K&T fixture tool stand. Kind of been off of it for a while, and I just want to get a little bit done. Okay, that was weird. Not really sure how much I'm gonna get done here. I'm kind of running low on gas for the MIG welder. Okay, that's strange. Let me go get a screwdriver, see if I can pry it up. I brought it back. It's almost like it's catching on a lip. Okay, that is totally strange. I'm not feeling a lip. Now this is a different head. doing the ring. Let me grab a hammer. Oh, you know what it looks like? It looks like I hit it with a side and it put a little ding in there. Let me see if I can grind that off and tack that back down. I don't like the way that that didn't hold. There was some oil on here, but I tried to wipe it off with acetone, but apparently it didn't work. Let me bring you back. I'm just going to buff that a little bit. I knew that there was, it felt like it was hanging up on a lip. You guys probably saw it in the camera, but I never actually saw it when I was trying to figure out why it wouldn't come out of there. I'll find out when I edit it. Okay. That's better. to do this grinding thing over here. Too. Cool. I'm gonna let that cool down a little bit, and then I'll come back over and stitch weld it. This is that I-beam that I'm gonna use for the legs on the K&T stand. The one was 16 inches long, so I'm just cutting this other one to the same length. I'll have a little bit left over. What I did is I went down to my steel supply house, and they were kind of busy, so I just kind of walked around and picked out drops from whatever I thought would work, and because I did that, picked it all out myself and got it up to the counter, guy gave me a real good deal on it. So he didn't charge me book price on it. What he did is he weighed it, charged me by the pound, so I got a real good deal on it. So that's kind of why I have this I-beam instead of angle iron for the feet of the legs. I'm just going to use this I-beam. There were some drops laying around. I thought, yeah, they'll work. Either I can set them upright or I can set them on the side and weld it into the channel for more stability, but I just thought I'd give you a shot of that. This is that plate for the K&T mill. What I'm going to do is just round the corners off on it, on the top of it. Bring it back when I do the other side. That's kind of what you end up with. That's unground. It's got slag on the back of it, dross, but I'll grind that off and take those edges off a little bit. But I'll bring you back. I didn't know whether you wanted to see this. This is how I just set it up. Kind of line up the radius on the edges. And then take a, this has got a beveled on it, and I don't really know how square it is. I just found it laying around, but just kind of square it up, line the edges up, and then I'll just clamp it down. I kind of pulled out of that one because I didn't know how close I was getting to cutting that clamp. So I kind of got that little edge there, but again, I'll just grind that off. And here's the back side of it. Very bad.